evening. Now, I want you to do something for me. I want you to finish this question. How can I keep from
singing?
And that's just how we all feel this evening. We love doing this music for you. Welcome to Kitsap Community Chorale's Spring Concert from 2018. If you look at your programs, you will note that our theme this evening is love, hope, faith, and coffee. And I figured it out. Took a while. In the Northwest, we love our coffee. We hope our order will be right, but we have faith in our barista. Thank you. All right. Our first piece, How Can I Keep From Singing, is based on Quaker lyrics set to a gospel melody by Greg Gilpin, who is a prolific composer and arranger, and the fellow who started playing the piano at age 4. He's really, really good. So, we will continue. Sit back. Oh, golly, I forgot the most important stuff. Bathrooms in the hallway behind us. Exits over that way where you see the green signs. And please, there's one more thing, and most of you know what it's going to be. Please take out your phones, put them on silent, and if you won't expire from separation anxiety, you could even turn them off. I tried. All right. So now you can sit back, relax, tap your toes, listen. You might even clap a time or two. We'll have a little surprise thrown in there now and then. Thank you. We're so glad you're here tonight.
I Behold Your Beauty is a 16th century Italian love song by Giovanni Gastaldi, written in the Belletto style, which is reminiscent of the English madrigal. You'll notice that the alternation of smooth lyrical lines with playful, dance-like fa-la-las. American composer Z. Randall Stroop set a late 19th century poem by Sarah Teasdale to music, resulting in the beautiful Prelude to Peace. Please enjoy our thoughts on love.
Thank you.
Morton Lardson's Diretant is the final piece of his five-part work, Les Chansons de Roses, or Songs of Roses. The piece is based on the works of late 18th century German poet Rainer Maria Rilke, who wrote almost 400 poems in French in addition to his prolific German writing. First popularized in the 1950s by Nat King Cole, Unforgettable is a classic love song that has withstood the test of time. Following Unforgettable, our small group will present the Manhattan Transfer arrangement of A Nightingale Sang in Berkeley Square.
Abandon, entourez, abandon, ton test chante. Unforgettable.
That's what you are.
That's what you are.
Unforgettable.
Though near or far,
though near or far,
like a song of love that clings to me, how the thought of you does things to me. Never before has someone been
and forevermore. Closing out our section on love is the lush, romantic piece, I Loved You. Alexander Pushkin is considered one of Russia's greatest poets. Though he only lived to the young age of 37, his romantic narrative poetry continues to inspire composers like J. Rose to set his beautiful words to music. Wanting Memories was written by Yasay Barman, a member of the African-American ensemble called Sweet Honey in the Rock. Besides her prolific catalog of compositions for dance, choral, film, and stage productions, Ms. Barnwell is known for her vocal range as a female bass. Listen to our bass and tenor sections replicate the sounds of percussion as the upper parts tell a beautiful story. Thank you.
many artists, including The Hollies, Neil Diamond, and Bill Medley, have recorded the popular song, "He Ain't Heavy, He's My Brother." While stories about the origin of its lyrics and title differ, one thing is certain: it communicates the message of universal love for our fellow human beings. Rounding out this half of our program is "Distant Land, A Prayer for Freedom," written by popular 20th century English composer John Rutter. The lush, melodic lines accompany the lyrics of "Hope," which were written in 1990, a time in history that saw the demolition of the Berlin Wall and the release of Nelson Mandela from prison. And following our thoughts on hope, there will be a brief pause.
The road is long. Everyone. My name is Courtney Turnley, and I am the president of the Kitsap Community Chorale Board, and I just want to thank you for being such a wonderful audience so far tonight, and I hope you've enjoyed the first half of our concert. Tonight, we are going to be raffling, well, you saw them when you came in, a couple of baskets that were out on the tables as you walked in, and they were put together by the alto, the soprano, and the tenor bass of the chorale. We are going to have some people right now. Now is the time we're going to draw the ticket. So why don't, while I finish up, we go ahead and bring those baskets in, and we're going to have some chorale members coming around. And if you would like to purchase another ticket, or you hadn't had a chance to purchase tickets yet, we're going to go ahead and give a minute to do that. Okay, they're bringing them in right now. So I just wanted to remind everyone that the Kitsap Community Chorale is a 501c3 organization, and all donations that you make to our organization are tax deductible. If you're looking to donate to a worthy cause, we welcome donations of any size to help us keep this beautiful music coming. To help make giving easier, we can now take debit cards or credit cards, and we'll be available directly afterwards if you would like to help keep this music going. We would like to publicly thank Linda Varda and George Dr. Malador and My Printing Services and Richard Dykstra for their donations to the chorale. So now, would anyone like any additional tickets? We have people coming around. Okay. Oh, he's got him. Okay. Okay, so.
You know you want some tickets.
Yep. So just go ahead and take a second. Well, where you're standing, you can take a stretch break while we're doing this brief pause. But we encourage you to go ahead and get back in, stay in here and get back in your seat. After we draw for the baskets. Thank you.
We have a real handsome young man named Kellen who's going to help us with the ticket drawing. He has absolutely no connection to any of those tickets, so it's going to be totally fair. So give me just a second to kind of mix them up a little bit, and then I'll hand it to Kellen. This is for the soprano basket, Summer Fun.
stretching it out. Let's see. This is from this evening. So the number is 470124. You got this eternal basket. Okay. It's a
Would
big.
You like me to walk it back to you?
Oh, okay.
I'm assuming she didn't ride here on a bicycle. Yes, that's. All right, let's look at. Now, this is the alto basket from the awesome Altos. And this is the gourmet kitchen basket. So hang on, Kellen, let me mix them up. He's got a sense for the dramatic. All right, let's see. Oh, this one is a name. Let's see. Whoops. I think it's from this afternoon. Let's double check the number. 470-038. I think that's a winner from this afternoon's concert.
So you hang on to that.
Oh, lovely. Perfect. We'll be sure to get that to him. We'll give him a call. All right. There's that one. Now, this seems to be the one that has the most interest. We obviously have a lot of people here who are desperately in need of a romantic night. All right, I'm mixing. This includes a couple bottles of wine. This is the adult, this is the, you know, 21 and over basket. All right, I mixed it up, I really have. All right, Kellen, last one. All right, what do we have? We have Kathy Hogan. Wow, outstanding, outstanding. So, Kathy Hogan for the romantic night. So, somebody's in for some fun. Like to hear that. Thank you all of you who participated. Thank you so much. We really do appreciate the support.
Listen to the storm. Thank you.
Speaking to faith in God during troubling times, we opened this section of our program with Secure by Susan Bersma and Craig Courtney. We continue our faith journey with the gospel Total Praise, which quotes Psalm 121. Lord, I will lift mine eyes to the hills, knowing my help is coming from you. The traditional spiritual Wade in the Water was masterfully arranged by Mark Hayes and features our wonderful accompanist, Crystal.
See that thoughts on faith, please enjoy our small group who begins our triple shot coffee break with Manhattan Transfer's Java Jive, followed by the entire chorale on Just Give Me Some Joe and Coffee in a Cardboard Cup.
cappuccino!
Black coffee!
In a cardboard cup!
Take a moment, you know, while we're waiting for Bailey to come back. I think she had to take a restroom break. I have some thank yous. I have to say a big thank you to Crystal, our lovely accompanist, my right and left hand. We truly could not do this job without Crystal. I am really not that great on piano. And we also have some people who are helping out in the house tonight. I cannot see them. I am blinded. But there's Herschel right there, our lovely house manager, handsome house manager. He runs a lovely tight ship. Thank you so much. Back on soundboard, we have Russ. Thank you, Soundman Russ. Extraordinaire. We have our wonderful stagehand, Bo. I don't know where Bo's at. There he is right there. On video, we have Leah back here. Thank you, Leah, for helping. And helping us out with some instrumentation, we have Dave Mahowski on percussion. And on bass, we have Urban Joseph. And so without further ado, we have one more piece tonight, and this is, I love this piece, and I think you guys do too. It's called I Sing Because I'm Happy, but we kind of wondered if it should be called I'm Happy Because I Sing, because we noticed that we are very happy when we come, and we especially can do a program for you, for wonderful ears who are listening and enjoying and appreciating. So thank you so much for taking time this evening to join us. So with that, we love to present I Sing Because I'm Happy. Oh, where's Bailey? 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 We need you. Here she is. Here she is. for taking part in your evening. We have enjoyed singing for you, and now we would love to visit with you in our cafe and have a treat or two as we thank you in person. So thanks again for coming. You are a lovely audience.
Oh. And the last thank you. This has been hard work, but you've worked hardest of all.
Oh, thank you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.